Hi, welcome to the episode 6 of Azure Data Factory full course tutorial. In this video, we will see how to create the data set for connecting to your Azure SQL database. In the last episode, we have seen to create data set for Azure Blob storage. And in this video, we will see data set for Azure SQL database. I'm Deepak Goyal, having 12 years of experience in IT, and I am a certified Azure Solution Architect. I'll take you through this complete series of Azure Data Factory tutorial. So let's go to the Azure portal and see how we can create our data set. Log into your portal.azure.com and go to your Azure Data Factory account. If you don't have Azure Data Factory account yet, you can go to this top video. There I have shown you how to create your Azure Data Factory account from scratch. So let's click on this. Go to the Author and Monitor tab. And this will take you to Azure Data Factory home screen. On the left hand side, you will see Author tab. Just click on Author tab. Here you see the pipeline dataset data flows. Either you can click on this plus sign or you can just click on here on dataset to create the new dataset. Now, when you have to create a data set, it will ask you to select the type of a data set. As we want to create a data set for our Azure SQL database, you have to select the SQL database. Here it's an option. So I've selected data set type as Azure SQL database. Give the data set name. SQL dataset. For creating dataset, you must have to have a link service. So in this case, we need to have a link service which can connect us to Azure SQL database. In the episode 4, we have already created the link service for SQL DB. So just select that. And if you haven't created yet, just click on new and create it. I am using the already created link service. And it will ask you to select the table name. And you can also give the parameters, but I want to keep this as a very simple for this. So I'll just select the table available. So I want to say, select a specific product table. So I'll select the product table and say okay. So this data set now will point to the product table of our database. Here, once it gets created, you can see the sign of Azure SQL, so that just by looking at the sign of it, anyone can know that this dataset is for Azure SQL. And you can just click on this preview data to just check whether it is fetching the data correctly or not. So you can see that it is pulling the data from this salesLT.product. So you can see this information. So our dataset creation has been successful. By this, we have created a dataset which can point to the product table into the Azure SQL database. So there are other ways also to create the dataset where you can give the dynamic table name using the parameter. So a single data set can point to a multiple tables using the parameters which you provide. But I want to keep it simple. For now, we have created a data set which is pointing to a specific table. In the upcoming videos, we will see how we can create a dynamic data set where a single data set can connect to a multiple tables. I hope you have enjoyed this session and you have really learned a new thing today on how to create a data set for Azure SQL Database. Please press the like again if you really like this video. And as I always say, if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, please do subscribe to the channel so that you can keep watching the new videos which I am putting on my channel on a daily basis.